Welcome to this presentation on mapping land cover for historical ecology. We will talk about using and comparing land cover information from all cadasters, aerial photographs, and modern databases. First, why to map past land cover? We know that past land use can affect present biodiversity, and sometimes past landscape structure can affect the present plant community composition more than present landscape structure. And we use past land cover as a proxy to record past land use. In historical ecology, several researchers use cartography to map only one land cover class, generally forest patches. These works are based mainly on topographic maps, and there is no difference in that case among different kinds of agricultural land cover. But studies on non-forest elements are growing in recent years, and they require a more detailed knowledge of agricultural land cover. Particularly, we need to distinguish arable land from grassland patches. Yet, there are two types of difficulties for extensive land cover mapping, including different agricultural land covers. At first, mapping past land cover is highly time-consuming. So, the first question is how to make it automatic or semi-automatic. Secondly, land covers at different historical periods need to be compared in order to get a unique land cover typology. And this step is crucial. The question is how to compare land cover information coming from different historical sources. Of course, land use change is ongoing, but there are some key periods of land use change in the modern era. The first period is the beginning of the 19th century. It's a peak in population density and land use pressure in rural areas. It's also the beginning of urbanization of the industrial era in urban areas. Land cover of that period can be studied in using all cadasters. The second period is 1950s. The 50s are the period of the beginning of extensive mechanization and the intensification of agriculture in rural areas. This is also the period of post-war reconstruction in urban areas. Thirdly, the 80s are the moment where the effects of the common agricultural policy are easy to observe in the landscape, particularly in terms of landscape homogenization. It's also the period of suburban extension and urban sprawl. And the land cover of 20th century is studied using aerial photographs. All cadastres have been produced in most European countries in the 19th century, at the beginning of 19th century, particularly for fiscal purposes. And they were produced at the parcel scale, which is very interesting for us. They are known to be accurate and precise because of these reasons, fiscal reasons of their creation. And they include the whole range of land cover classes, including difference between grasslands and arable land. The old cadastres are composed of two elements, parcel maps and parcel registers. Parcel maps are drawn up on a scale varying according to the density of the element represented, and this density is not the same in rural or in urban areas. And parcel registers mention in a very accurate way the type of land cover for each parcel. About aerial photographs, most countries have carried out photographic land surveys on a large spatial scale and at regular time intervals, which gives us the possibility to identify land cover and capture landscape changes. And moreover, these images are generally freely available on governmental websites, and this is why The use of vertical aerial photographs is common in historical ecology and landscape studies. We can use black and white photographs from the 40s or color photographs from the 90s. We can also use near-infrared photographs often used in forest studies in order to identify wetlands and chlorophyll activity. There are three main steps in land cover mapping: georeferencing past images, vectorization of land cover patches and some key linear elements, and classification of land cover patches to link polygons to a specific land cover class. In this slide, you have some examples where graphic quality of the image is insufficient to proceed with semi-automatic vectorization. On the left and in the center, you have two examples of old cadastre from the 19th century. As you can see, there are some words. There is a written information on the image. On the right, you have an aerial photograph from the 50s. Where the colors are not enough contrasted. The semi-automatic vectorization is possible, but the result is not very good. After manual vectorization, the classification of past land cover can be done by checking 19th century land cover on cadastral registers, parcel by parcel, and this step is very time-consuming. When automatic vectorization is possible, corrections of the vectorized image are often needed in order to merge unfairly divided plots or split unfairly aggregated plots, as shown on the right, but also in order to avoid overlaps and gaps, to integrate linear elements, or to eliminate two small polygons. Our second question was how to compare land cover information coming from different historical sources. We need to result in a single land cover classification and to make compatible information coming from very different historical periods. For instance, we need to compare information coming from old cadastres from the 19th century and present modern databases. This step necessarily leads to a loss of information compared to the most precise information, which is generally the most recent. And we can observe that less precise source determines the final land cover categorization. To correctly integrate past land cover in the unique land cover classification, it's very important to understand past land use terminology, which requires historical information on past agricultural practices. For example, on the right, you can see some terms coming from the Napoleonic cadastre, the old cadastre of the beginning of the 19th century in France. We translated fallow land, but the original terms term was terven, which refers to a specific functioning of the pastoral system. Also, the term planted pasture refers to a kind of land cover which has almost disappeared today. Unlike the past, for the present, we have databases that are already georeferenced, vectorized, and informed, so it's not necessary to go through the three steps mentioned above: georeferency, vectorization, and classification of land cover. But it's necessary to integrate a set of databases coming from different sources, and particularly to add information on agricultural land to the classical and more conventional information of forests, cities, and aquatic areas. In France, the database on agricultural land cover requires two types of corrections. At first, splitting the crop block into several parcels, because this database is given at the scale of the crop block, not at the parcel scale. Secondly, it's necessary to fill some gaps by photo interpretation of the orthophotos. To conclude, semi-automatic mapping methods require careful adaptation to the specificities of the information sources. However, this step is crucial in understanding landscape changes. So if you have any suggestion, please tell us in the live discussion session. Thank you for your attention.